I never met him. You know, I did a food show called Ugly Delicious, and a bunch of people in that show, including David Chang and David Cho, were good friends with him. And so I knew from, you know, one step away how important he was to them. You know, everybody called him Uncle Tony, and he was kind of the godfather of the alternative food media scene. But everybody had utmost respect for him. And that's part of when he died. I knew that he meant so much more than just being a guy on TV that people liked, that he was actually important in what he was doing, you know, both in front of the camera and behind the camera. When I first started cutting the film, I just started at the beginning, and I didn't want to think or talk about his death because I didn't want that to kind of infect the entire film and for it to feel like a eulogy or something. So we just started at the beginning and told that story of him having that flush of success where Kitchen Confidential takes off and then he gets a TV show and all the excitement of that. And when I put it all together, it seemed like we are never going to get to the ending. And so I wanted to put something in the beginning that reminds people that we know where the story is going and we'll get there, but we're going to take our time getting there, because, you know, we tend to read history backwards, but we live our lives forward. And so I just wanted to make sure that the film felt like we were actually on this journey with him, and that the answer wasn't preordained.